So Brett, they were giving you a lot of guff on the panel for being the new guy. Is that something that happens often to you on the other side of the show as well?
No, actually, look, I'm just happy that somebody took a chance and had more faith in my ability than I do sometimes.
You are a motorcycle, right?
Yeah.
You mean like get on this rope thing?
Yeah. And so they set up all these cool things and they just were like, yeah, you can do that, right? So I just sort of stepped into the role. But I'm just happy they took a chance on me. And as I was sort of like kind of mentioning in there, like, I think I was running like all the blog stuff before, and like, wait, who is this guy? I knew he plays this character, who is this guy? So, I am a newbie, but they are the most welcoming group of people.
You wouldn't know it by anything. I think for me, especially me, you, Ian, and Elizabeth, we were all relatively, all very new and
different shades of green.
Yes, exactly. I would be forest green. You would be lime green. And so you wouldn't know it though. They just trust us, and that's a little scary, but it's really flattering, and it's great.
And Whedon has a history of sort of giving people roles that haven't had a ton of stuff beforehand, like Buffy. So I think that he, you know, I think he knows a good thing. That's going to sound awful.
Can you guys tell us a little bit about your characters since you're starting new?
Yeah. All right. I play Sky, and she's a computer hacker. I have a spiel. I have a Sky here. And she finds her way. She stumbles into the S.H.I.E.L.D. world, and she definitely stirs it up a bit. And she's got a history, and it's interesting. It's going to be really cool to watch that unfold throughout the season. I don't know it yet. We're on episode 2. We will find out. And she's kind of Coulson's last puzzle piece of putting together this team of this ragtag team of people who just never really met, never really interacted, who have all these different assets, but don't really know how to use it in a team situation. So.
Yeah, and in some ways we're the polar opposite. I mean, you do all of your work behind a computer, and I do all the playing in the field. And you know, I feel like Ward is like a Swiss Army knife. Like, he has a tool for every situation, but he's just not used to working with other people. He's used to being the entire solution. And you know, it'll be interesting to see how this lone wolf becomes part of a wolf pack.
I love it. What do you say then?
Can we talk about the interaction?
Can we talk about your shirt for a second?
Excuse me, I know it's for you, buddy.
And yours, the coat.
It's Bill Coulson on it, too?
Hold on.
Let's see, like, that's like
that's
a
vintage.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's awesome.
Everyone is
representing. That's nice. It's officially licensed, really?
Yeah.
That's cool, too. That is. You guys, no one brought it besides these guys. Just kidding.
So just ignore the rest of the table, and we'll just go this way. So, anyway.
Well, can you talk about how Sky kind of changes characters or kind of sticks in the mud, like Grant Ward or Bill Coulson?
You know, Sky's one of those rare computer hackers that isn't one of those, like, girl with a dragon tattoo. I don't like people. She's a very personable, you know, girl, and she's very smart, and she knows exactly what she's doing. She may be acting a certain way, but she's doing it on purpose. So she's the yin and yang. Ward and Sky are definitely learning from each other, and they're just totally different. And it's going to be really, really nice to see these characters kind of feed off each other and grow from it, because
sometimes it bothers us.
We're so different, and then it's like, oh wait, I've never had someone give me that perspective on life or on whatever it was until now. And I think that's what's going to be interesting, and it could get a little romantic, who knows? It is ABC. So
I mean, off screen it already is, but
it
like,
is.
It's possible that he's
married with 5 kids.
Joining the world of the Avengers with these larger than life heroes, is it intimidating for you coming in as the human characters without special abilities other than your wits and computer skills?
No, I think there's
that's what makes the show relatable. It's because we're like, it's set in the real world, even though it's Marvel Universe, so it's set in the real world. It's like, I mean, this is how real human beings, with really cool skills, but real human beings would react to things. Sometimes we don't know how to do that. I think that's more interesting. In some respects, having a superpower.
Yeah, what this show is about the superhuman world filled with superheroes, and then these super ordinary people compared to the Hulk or Thor dealing with that. So that's what's.
You know what?
That's,
because not all heroes are super.
Not all heroes are super.
You guys talk about folks who put together this team for a specific purpose. Can you talk about the team dynamic and what that team means, what you guys are doing together?
You know, I don't think they know. From where we are now, I don't think the team exactly knows why Wilson is doing this. I think it'll gradually happen. Does that make sense?
We're saving the world. We're saving.
Well, yes. We're here because Coulson sees the bigger picture and he's like, these people are incredible and they're going to be even more incredible together. It's all about
we're making sure the wrong powers. These powers don't end up in the wrong hands.
The world before each other, why is it bringing us together? Does that make sense?
Yeah, for each other, I don't think we.
No.
I mean, some of us saw the pilot, some of us didn't, but you guys get to play off each other quite a bit in the pilot. Is that a dynamic you feel is going to develop as the show goes along? You guys really play off each other often?
I definitely
not so
would agree.
They're taking you guys away. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you guys.